Coming up on KCTV, our final program of the year takes a look at the schedule for next week.
And a look at the Centennial Cafeteria that will hopefully give us some food for thought.
All this and more because KCTV starts right now.
Kim Possible, this is an emergency.
Your basic average girl, and I'm here to save the world. You can't stop me cause I'm Kim Possible. There is nothing I can do when danger closes. Know that I am on my way.
In just a little over 1 week from now, we'll be on vacation. I'm Danielle Burtz.
And I'm Hannah Hepschman. Welcome to KCTV. Here are just a few reminders to get us through the end of the school year. This will be a three-day weekend, so we won't have school on Monday. Afternoon finals will be Tuesday and Wednesday. Morning finals will be next Thursday and Friday. The school year culminates with graduation at 11 o'clock on Saturday morning, June 1st at the Taco Bell Arena, as about 300 seniors receive their high school diplomas.
The end of the school year is a great time to give thanks to teachers and staff. KCTV's Kyle DeVille takes a look at one group.
9 o'clock on a typical school day. The cafeteria is quiet. But while all the students are in class, the food technicians are hard at work.
Well, there's four of us that get here at about 5:30 in the morning, and we start breakfast then. And then at about 8:30, 9 o'clock, all the rest of the girls are in here, and we start lunch. So it takes us all day, and we're hustling all day long.
Not only do they get here early, but they have to prepare a ton of food for the Centennial students.
I get a delivery every Tuesday, and it's over $1,200 worth of food every week.
The school recommends every student get at least three items at lunch, and one of those being half a cup of fruit.
So they are offered five, they're required to get three, and one of those needs to be a half a cup of fruit or vegetable, and that's the main thing we look for.
Every day there are different options for the Centennial students to pick from. Even though right now there are multiple options on the menu, there could be even more options coming next year.
Oh, probably some new wraps, maybe some different burgers coming next year. We'll keep the spices because we know you guys like them.
These women are hard at work every day to make the food we love. But with hard work also comes friendship.
These gals are great. We have a lot of fun. That's the only way to do your job.
Centennial High School, Kyle DeVille, KCTV.
Good morning, Patriots. Today we're talking about dreams. And I don't mean daydreams. I mean dreams that you're passionate about and that you would like to achieve in your lifetime. Dreaming is good for you. It's good for your soul. And when your dreams come true, you feel excitement and happiness. So you want to set goals, take action, and dream big. Think of dreams as like a ladder. And your dream is at the top of the ladder. Really, really big ladder that a fireman would use to like put out a burning building. So as you're climbing up the rungs of the ladder, obviously you're going to stumble and you're going to have self-doubt and there may be people that get in your way of your dreams, but you just keep plugging along the ladder and reaching for your dream. And then finally, when you reach the top of the ladder, you're going to find that it wasn't maybe about the dream at all, it was about the journey getting to the dream. So dream big, think about the journey, don't let people get in your way. And there has been some research that says if you write your dreams down, they'll actually come true. Make a list of your dreams and see how many of them you can fulfill. C.S. Lewis said, "You are never too old to set a new goal or dream a new dream." So this summer, dream big, take action, set goals, and I will see you next year right here at KCTV.
Finally, if you're looking for something fun to do, this summer, you might look right in front of you. KCTV's Emily Liu explains.
Drawing. A picture or diagram made with a pencil, pen, or crayon rather than using paint. But why do people like it?
It kills time when you're bored. On a road trip, you can draw. And when you got nothing to do, you can draw all the other stuff.
It helps just in kind of relaxing when you've had a hard day and it's been stressful. Sometimes it's a good stress relief. think it gives me a lot of self-satisfaction, just like anything else that you put a lot of work into.
There are still some people who don't like drawing, so here are some helpful tips for them.
There actually are some books out right now, not necessarily drawing, but coloring in different designs that are supposed to relieve stress. So I suppose they're finding out that there are some benefits to that as far as stress relief.
Well, if you still can't draw, at least you'll have fun doing it. From Centennial High School, Emily Liu, KCTV.
And that's KCTV for you today. I'm Danielle Burtz.
And I'm Hannah Hupschman. Have a great summer.
When will I see you again? When will we share precious moments?